Today, we're taking an initial look and giving away one of the all-new Rally pedal-based power meters from Garmin. What's up, ladies and gentlemen of the internet? Some big changes to Garmin's power meter lineup today. Today they announced three new pedal-based power meters. The Rally RS, which is their new Shimano SPD SL compatible cleat. The Rally XC, which is their new Shimano SPD compatible cleat for off-roading. And the Rally RK, which is similar to their previous Vector style pedals in that they use that look style cleat. And each of these different pedals comes in either a dual-sided or a single-sided power meter variety, meaning that you can pay a little bit less and you can get a set of pedals that is only providing power from the left cleat, and then it's doubling that value to give you, you know, a working value. So this is the RK200, and that's the dual, and the RK100 would be the single-sided version. So that's the naming convention there. Now, I only have the Rally RK pedals to review currently, but I'll try and get my hands on the other two models in the near future. In particular, that Rally XC model looks pretty cool for off-road power meter testing. But Garmin did provide me with these pedals for the purpose of this review, but they are not sponsoring this video. No money is changing hands, and no one gets to see this video before you guys get to see it right here on YouTube. And whenever a company sends me something to review, I do try to pass it along to one of you guys in the form of a giveaway. So stick around to the end of this video and we'll talk about how we can make that happen. And I do think that this is going to be the most expensive item that I've ever given away on this channel. The price of this, the Rally RK 200s, is $1,100. The left-only version, the RK100, cost $650. So that's $100 more than the Vector 3s were, and $50 more than the Vector 3S, which was the left-only power meter version of that product. And we're looking at the exact same price for that Rally RS, which is that SPD SL cleat, but the Rally CX costs an extra $100. So that's $1,200 for the dual power meter and $50 extra for the single-sided variety. And if you do decide to go with the 100 series product or the left-only power meters, you can purchase a dual power meter upgrade kit. It's basically $550 for the RK and the RS variety, a little bit more for that Rally XC. It's $600 for the upgrade kit of that one. Now, one of the things that I think is really quite interesting that Garmin is doing with this new whole series of power meters that they have is they give you the option to purchase a pedal body conversion kit, meaning that you can take your Rally RK pedals and you can convert the pedal body to something like the Rally XC pedals. So, you know, I personally haven't gone through the conversion process. It doesn't look super difficult. The process is pretty similar to, you know, servicing your pedal bearings on your Vector pedals if you ever did that. My guess is it'll probably take you about 15 or 20 minutes if you have all the right tools. And I also think that athletes are probably gonna consider doing something like this. I'm guessing it'll be one of those kind of seasonal things, potentially using your RK in the summertime for road biking and things like that. Maybe doing the switch for cyclocross season or riding gravel or something like that during the winter time. But the Rally RS and the Rally RK cost $200 for the pedals, and that XC cost $250 for that pedal conversion kit. Okay, in the box of the Rally RK, you've got the pedals themselves, install instructions, safety details about the product, but they've also provided you with the red float level look KO cleats in the bolts that attach the cleats to the cycling shoes. I just used the cleats that I already had on my cycling shoes. There's nothing special about the cleats that they provide to you. They're not proprietary or anything weird like that. Any sort of look KO cleats should work with these pedals. Now the RK pedals themselves, they have a claimed weight of 326. You know, I weighed them at 331 grams together, 166 grams a piece. If you are comparing weight with, you know, some sort of other pedaling system, I would probably suggest, you know, weighing the entire cleat and pedal system with the attachments and the bolts and things like that. Just because, you know, for example, like Speed Play, they're always gonna be a little bit lighter, but they do tend to have a little bit more weight in the way that they actually attach to the cycling shoe itself. So when I weighed, you know, this pedal, the bolts and the cleats themselves, I weighed these in at 406 grams, just for your reference. Now the stack height of this particular pedal is 12.2, which is the exact same as the Vector 3S's were. And if you're calculating the Q factor, the pedal width, you know, from the end of the threads to the middle of the platform base is 53 millimeters, but it's 55 millimeters if you use that washer that's provided with the pedals themselves. And the pedals, they come with the lowest tension set, just so, you know, if you are new to clipping in, hopefully it's a little bit easier for you to go through that process. I mentioned the washers. The goal of these washers is just to kind of keep the power meter threaded area from kind of poking through and actually coming into contact with the chain of the bike. They're not required by any means, but you do want to be careful that you leave a little bit of clearance between the actual pedal spindle and the actual chain when you have the chain in its lowest gears, meaning you've got your chain in the big gear, big chain ring in the front, and the smallest one in the back. That'll kind of push the chain as close to the pedals as possible, and you can make sure that you have enough clearance. The instructions that come with the actual product say, you know, suggest 2 millimeters of spacing. For me personally, I use the washers on my road bike, but then I didn't use them on my TT bike. And really, you know, I didn't have any issues either way. To install these pedals, super simple. All you need is a 15 millimeter pedal wrench. Slap it on there, turn the pedal a couple of times. There is like a little, you know, indicator light. You'll get, you know, a green blinking light, and then you're good to go searching for it, you know, with your bike computer. I use the 530. I also use the Wahoo Bolt, had no problems connecting to it either way. And I also tried it on my Garmin Enduro watch, still no issues. 15 minutes or so is really all it took for me to install these. I was kind of in a rush because I was running out to meet some friends. No problem getting it installed. Okay, I guess now is as good a time as any to mention that there is still a maximum weight of 231 pounds or 105 kilograms, same as the Garmin Vectors were. So, you know, if you're watching this video and you have a donut in one hand, and you know, some sort of delicious pastry in the other, you're in a safe place here, judgment-free zone, but you might wanna slowly, you know, put those babies down and back away. Now, the Rally RK200s are extremely similar to that Vector 3, but it does look like they've improved some really important pieces. And the big one is the battery door. The battery door on the Vectors were kind of notorious for kind of causing issues and dropouts and things like that. The batteries were coming separate and rattling around in here. And it does look like Garmin has addressed those issues. They've addressed them both with the Vector 3s, you know, as they kind of change manufacturing process, kind of mid-build there, as well as with these. The battery door on these particular pedals comes off with a 4 millimeter pedal wrench. And you can actually see here that they've switched battery types. They're using a CR1-3 style battery instead of two smaller batteries. So seems to be working fine for me. I haven't had any dropouts or any issues with my personal testing, although my testing has been limited. And I also haven't really ridden enough to kill the batteries, but Garmin is claiming that you can expect about 120 hours of usage. So if you are buying these or, you know, winning these, hopefully, you may want to go ahead and pick up a couple of spare batteries. I typically recommend that people don't go ultra cheap on these batteries, just because I found out the hard way that, you know, some of those super cheap batteries don't seem to last all that long. I will go ahead and leave a link in the description of this video to some Duracells or, you know, some sort of battery that I think are a little bit more reasonable. Now, Garmin claims that the power meter accuracy on these pedals is plus or minus 1%. And generally speaking, I found this to be pretty spot on in my testing. I tested it against two other power meters. That's just kind of what I have on hand. And the data looks pretty solid. I've got two data sets for us to look at real quick. And in both cases, you know, I rode for a little while, basically, you know, warm up the equipment, and then I stopped to calibrate each of the power meters. And I actually, you know, I found that this is fairly helpful at getting kind of the most consistent results. But the long, easy ride here, you know, I'm comparing the Rally pedals to my Cork power meter. Overall, you know, the power meters tend to track pretty well. I would say that my Cork really always tends to be very generous with my power meter numbers. So, of course, I like the Cork, making me look good. But here's another data set, and you know, this time indoors, and I'm comparing the Rally power meter pedals to the Wahoo Kicker Core data. And they seem to track pretty closely. I did a few steady state minutes in here, and I do see one dropout just on the very last one here. And then I did a few short kind of pickups here towards the end, and all of it seems to track pretty well. Okay, so what are the advantages of going with something like the Garmin Rally pedals over, you know, other power meter pedals on the market? For one, you know, the obvious, you know, you get true left right power. It's not an estimate, it's not taking a number and doubling it, you know, assuming that you go with the 200 model series. But with that data, Garmin will let you do some pretty cool stuff. They call it their cycling dynamics metrics. You can look at left right balance, sitting time versus standing time, lots of interesting things to kind of analyze your pedal stroke. Also, we should definitely mention that it is fairly easy to swap these pedals between bikes. All you need is that pedal wrench. So that is fairly important when you're considering buying a power meter. It's also relatively easy to switch out those pedal body types. That's something that's, you know, very cool as of now being an option. As far as cons go, they're expensive. They're really expensive. The Vector 3s were $1,000. These Rally pedals cost $100 more. I'm not 100% sure what's up with the price bump. You know, might be the fact that they have upgraded some of the materials that are used, but you could save, you know, somewhere between like $200 and $300 by going with a different company like the Favera Asayama, which is also a dual power meter pedal. So, you know, you are paying a lot of money to get a premium product, you know, coming from Garmin here. Okay. To win these very slightly used Garmin Rally RK200s, all you need to do is subscribe to the channel and then drop below in the comments area and let me know, you know, what you think about these power meters and the power meter market in general. There's actually a lot of new power meters that are coming onto the power meter market right now. It's an interesting time for sure, but I'm gonna give this video a few weeks and then I'll use a random number generator to pick a comment. And then I'll just let you know, and we can connect over private message on Instagram or someplace like that, so that I can get all of your shipping information and send these your way. And you know, I don't mind shipping it to somewhere in North America, but if it does get significantly farther away than that, we can chat, you know, over private message about your options that way. And I'm gonna leave just a few more details just regarding the giveaway in the description of this video. So be sure to go ahead and check that out. Okay, so those are my initial thoughts of the Garmin Rally RK200 power meter. I personally think that it's super cool that Garmin is kind of expanding their lineup, you know, past just the look style pedal bodies. And I really think that it's gonna make, you know, a lot of off-road cyclists really happy to have some more additional options. But as always, I'd love to kind of take this opportunity just to remind you guys to get out there, swim, bike, run, rinse, and repeat it all over again. And we will see you guys on the next video.